And then he held my hand. And all of a sudden I saw that the Lord and I were hovering over a certain place. We were hovering over the sea. And there was a certain cloud. The skies looked like fire. And it was so fearful, beloved. The fire of the Lord filled the sky. And all of a sudden I heard a voice say that the Lord's book of life has been closed.
It is time for us to wake up from our slumber. It is time for us to set up a shield of the living. sister and cobalt as a phone number, Sister Sada and Timmy Ekubia.
And in the vision I saw, by the grace of God, the Lord shared with people regarding all their gold, all their possessions as though it was dung.
Let's add that your cobalt and who nipa and after your video will see how poor they are doing in Anno.
And we are trying to involve this thing in the cloth that we wear, the Son
to be a day of complaints and total justice.
The Lord said that through everything
Beloved,
the Lord has been knocking upon the door of our hearts, but how many of us are open unto him?
The Lord has been knocking upon the door of our hearts, but how many of us are open unto him?
Yeah. Had I known that the same, had I known, I would have given everything, all my money, all my wealth for this great God.
before.
There is a limit. There is a time limit to the salvation of the law. And in that day, people will realize that it is too late. May the Lord help us so that it shall never be our portion. And the Lord also showed me certain people who have fixed their eyes on the law. And then
there
is and when they begin to listen to it immediately, they also fall asleep. Immediately, the demons will set in, capture them, and they also fall asleep. And the Lord said that all those who are fall asleep in Him will not make it on that day.
And he said
he is about to submit the names of the saints unto the Father. And those whose names are not found written in the book of life will not make it. And on the
23rd
day of May, by the grace of God, our Lord Jesus Christ appeared unto me again. And we were at church here, and my mother led me to the office because the Lord said He has something to reveal.
And
when I went in there, our Lord Jesus Christ held my hand. And He said He's going to show me certain things that will happen afterwards. So I should not be afraid. And all of a sudden I saw that we were in hell. That dreadful place. Which is not the habitation of any human being at all. And I saw a very large cage. I couldn't really even see the end of the cage. And there were many countless number of demons in the cage. And they were holding on to the cage. Beloved, one can only imagine? The demons look so black. And they look so filthy. And you
can
see that the moment they are released, they are going to pounce upon humanity with full force. And the Lord said that I should run his church. I should run each and every one of us here. That we should be careful. Especially those who speak his truth. We should be careful so that nothing will hinder us. Because there is a dark time ahead of humanity. So we should try our best to be in that number. May the Lord help us all. Please, if you're writing, you can kindly write down 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 4 and verse 5. And
then
the Lord said that, for if God spared not the angels that sinned, but cast them down to hell, and delivered them into chains of darkness to be reserved unto judgment. The word of the Lord here spoke of these angels, the fallen angels, being caged unto that day of judgment. And after this, our Lord Jesus Christ was raised quickly to another place. And I saw that we were all at a place like a stadium, it was like a field. And we were all having white garments on with people who also practice holiness. And we were all running, about to run a race. We were all even running a race. And I saw that we had these white beautiful garments on. And the Lord made me understand by his grace that we all need to get to the finishing line at a certain time.
Now you are just supposed to come to me say, I was saying you know you're too big to and we can turn away here and bring you on your mind.
So there is a set time for that race.
I just said, I'm going to be on my own, I was saying we can turn away and bring
you. So you need to run with everything that is within us.
I said, I was saying too many more than you know, it's from me, come on.
And we were supposed to cast off everything that will serve us in weight so that we'll be able to get there in time.
Now I was saying, you may be a very clear sign and I'm a very clear about how can we be a sign we'll be to me.
So the garments we had on were very light. And though the Lord was revealing this to me by his grace, I saw that at the same time, in a strange way, I was also running the race. But then the sad thing is that some of those running the race had certain notes upon their head.
That's what some of us say, what are we doing?
Some of them were carrying it in their
hands.
And because of that, they were not able to run as they ought. And the Lord said that even as the time is almost up, one needs to let go of all those weights that they are carrying in order to cross the finishing line.
And one's
eyes needs to be focused on the Lord. And on the race that we are running. But certain people fix their eyes on the things that they are holding. And the Lord said that we need to run it with diligence, the race with diligence, and we use the words that we need to run so that we may obtain. But then the people were still holding on to their notes.
Instead
of throwing them away and running the race ahead.
That
the Lord by His grace showed me some of the loads the people were carrying. And I saw that one of the loads was called riches. So I asked the Lord, please, how can someone be practicing holiness and carry a load of riches? They think that no one sees them. behold the risen great God who sees everything. And he is the one going to stand as our judge on that day. The Lord showed me the first woman with such a stain in the garment. And that woman's husband doesn't usually treat her well. So she went to talk with her husband. But then the husband said all sorts of bitter things to her. And after that, this woman had a certain bitterness in her heart. A certain anger within her. And that was the secret sin in her life. Because of that, she wasn't able to run the race as she had to. And the next person the Lord revealed was a man. And he had that deep stain in his and the hem of his garment. And the Lord explained that this person tries practicing holiness. But the person will go into a situation and say that as for today, I need to lie to get out of this situation.
And
the Lord said that person does not value heaven or his salvation. He doesn't count it to be of greater value. And because of that, the person decided to lie. And he thought that it is a very small sin. But in the sight of God, beloved, it is so great. And because of that, he also cannot be able to run the race as he ought to. And the Lord showed me the next person. And she was a woman with a child. And that woman was a child. So I was wondering, the Lord is taking care of your child a sin? And the Lord said that no. But this woman puts her child above the Lord. And instead of trusting in the Lord to take care of the woman and her child, the woman always thinks about the child so much. The Lord said that she was supposed to commit the child into the hands of God, and the Lord will help the woman run the race, and the child will also follow. And because of that, this woman also wasn't able to run as she had to. So I asked the Lord, do you please father, what should we also do? Is there any hidden sin found within us? And the Lord said that if we want to run, we shall all go before him. And even as the time is getting closer, even so does his grace abound. And he will reveal it unto us. And any sin we know of too, we should commit it into his hands, and he will help us to get rid of it. And the next day being the 25th of May, during the worship time, the Lord also told me by his grace that he wants to reveal something of the dark times ahead unto me. He introduced himself and said, "This is your Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ." And he showed me the horse in his hand. So after going to the office, the Lord by his grace handed scroll to me. And the Lord said, when the sin of Sodom and Gomorrah got before him, he decided to visit them with his fire. That's the wrath of his fire. But the sin of all humanity is greater than that of Sodom and Gomorrah. And the Lord showed me a great screen. And all this while, the Lord didn't allow me to open the scroll he gave me. And the Lord made me understand that is how the bad times ahead are going to be. And he showed me the entire full of darkness. Beloved, the skies were black.
Pitch
black.
There
was no source of light found in the sky. It was only by the grace of God that he even helped me to see what I saw. Beloved, the world was so full of darkness. And the Lord showed me certain skyscrapers and mansions and heavy cars that someone owned. And all of a sudden, they all began to melt away. Some of them I didn't see how they melted away. What even caused that? And some of them were never. And the Lord showed me the man who owned all those properties. And he explained that he was a man who always thought of money. All that he would think of when he wakes up in the morning is that today, how can I make more money? And the Lord asked, but
all
man, when will you be satisfied? All his riches couldn't save him. On that day, he was running away from
that.
Then the Lord showed me another lady on the screen. And he explained that she was a lady that loved the pleasures, the things of the world. She loved going out, spending time with her
friends.
But in that day, I saw her carrying the clothes of different colors that she was having. And she cast them all away. She cast away all those things that she was having. But on that day, you couldn't even differentiate between colors. On that day, this world had lost its beauty. All the beautiful colors, like the green trees we see out there, the beautiful things we see around us, all of them had changed color. They had become gray. They had lost its beauty.
Beloved,
one can only imagine what a day that will be. I cannot be able to fully describe how it was. But on that day, the skies were not the beautiful blue that we see. All the beautiful passed away. And the Lord also said, but now when he asked us to dress in a decent way, we complained. But on that day, it is going to be a day without shame. It is going to be a day of rest. Then the Lord at that time told me to open the scroll. And when I did, there were only 4 words in it, the 3 main words. And the words found in the scroll were words. Lamentations. And mourning. Words. Lamentations. And mourning. The Lord said that it is going to be a day of woes. A day of lamentations. And a day of mourning. It is going to be you could feel that the entire world, you could feel it by just looking, that the entire world was silent and mourning. As a widow mourns her husband who has departed. But then, beloved, on that day, there will be no other hope. And I saw people dressed in sackcloth and ashes. They were weeping uncontrollably.
Animals
Christ
said.
On that day, thou shalt
not treat thee at her feet.
No creature show
up their faces. And none of the waters shall give up their freshness. For they shall all hide their faces from the face of the Almighty. On that day, all the trees in this world will lose their life that is within them. On that day, the animals, the creatures in this world will go and find a hiding place. Why? Because of the wrath of the living God. And beloved, those are just creatures without any conscience. To surrender, how much more humanity?
And for Salome, Abadia, only Timbabia, and no media, see a prime minister.
Beloved, the great day of the living God is coming.
And for Salome,
a day of
love,
lamentations, and mourning.
And that is what we can't do. Beloved,
let us stop using the wisdom of this world as an excuse.
when you say we are seeing the young Sayan Katuhubiha.
And it's time for us to cast them all away.
And once you see a big time blessing that we're getting us in our trouble.
This month, all the bruised and sins that you suffer, nights and nights, I think you will spend through nights and nights studying, throwing your salvation away. But on that day, we cast the peace away and sought salvation and found not.
Sadly, your family has to, and the Madison woman's family.
On that day, none of the positions or titles that we are striving for will save you and I.
Suddenly, you did bring a good girl, and you're pressuring a beer with it, my dear boy.
None of you is going to intercede on our behalf. And then the Lord said,
when you were in the Christian council,
he also showed me people now seeking Bibles.
I think I'm a man who will be a man who will be
some of them were busy studying the Bibles. Some of them were holding on tight to it. Some of them were holding on tight to it.
They were also on the trust and number one thing.
And the Lord said, on that day,
Sadano,
when my spirit will inspire the word is gone.
Ah, no, I was saying Kenya and I shall say woman every moment.
What more shall man gain?
A dear woman, you can be to me.
For if they use it now, they shall not gain it later. It is time for us to hold on tightly to the word of God. I saw people going for wooden crosses, big wooden crosses, setting them on hills, hoping to gain salvation from them. And there was found no hope for them in that as well. The darkness on that day reminded me of the solar eclipse that took place in Ghana in the year
2006.
On that day, though I was young, I remember that countless of people, and I remember that on that day our dog that was in the house went into hiding. When they brought it on television, animals were hiding. But beloved, what about the day of the fury of God? The Lord said, that day of judgments will not be easy for angels. It will not be easy for even the angels. How much more, man? He also said, tell them to seek me now when I may be found. But that day is not far at all. May the Lord have mercy on us. And on the 30th day of May, whilst praying, our Lord Jesus Christ came to the room by his grace, showed the
roses
in his hands, and introduced himself as our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And he said, humanity has disappointed me, and very soon I will recompense their own evil upon their head.
Man
is making my blood waste. Tell my beloved children to be prepared, for I must soon come for my own.
Make sure
for the time is up. And you can see a big sorrow in the eyes of the Lord. And we had a
be Ellen and say.
And on the 5th of June.
Now, June, this will be the first one.
This very year.
Yeah, fear.
Our Lord Jesus Christ came to where we were when we were worshipping the Lord by His grace.
Yeah, and yes, so many young people are supposed to have done when you
and the Lord was weeping bitterly.
Now, if you want to know what's so you, Pam.
And He said, child, this is your Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. It's now time for me to take those who are mine home.
I
weep because I am sad. The reality has rejected the salvation that I have given. And it is now time for me to take those who are mine away. So tell them to put their houses in order. For the hour has fast spent and the time has run out. And child, this is your Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Beloved, do you really see that the time has run out?
For you, Jesus Christ, my answer is a miracle.
Our names found written in the book of life.
And
on the 23rd day of July,
this will be the first of the summer.
Just prayed and written upon the Lord with my mother.
All of a
sudden, I saw, by the grace of God, I saw that the clouds had opened. And the trumpet of the Lord sounded. And the saints of the Lord were caught up in the air. But those who just a few. And I heard the voice of the Lord saying, have you seen how few they are in number? Is your work going to be in vain? Tell my children to prepare well. And you could feel the sorrow coming from the Lord as He spoke. And may the Lord bless His word.